the drones can just catch up. What we're going to be looking at today is Unity. Unity is a games creator engine. It comes in a free version and it comes in a paid version. We've got the professional version only purely because one of the things we're working with it to do is actually to develop apps for pushing to iPods and iPads and such like. But today all we're going to be doing really is concentrating on the desktop version of Unity. So everyone should have a similar screen in front of you if your screen's blank, right over the mouse. Many people here slightly used to a Mac, or now most of the PC people, I'll be general with you, but there's not that much that likes to require. I've enabled the second button on it, so you can right click, which is a mercy. I'm only going to go through part one of this, which is basically the complete non-programming side of this. So what we're going to do is create an island today. We're going to put a volcano on it, put some sun on it, add a beach, that sort of thing. I'll show you through it, and then I'll let you have a go yourselves. If we're getting on great guns, then I may run off print off another document, which is all about adding some small elements of gameplay. It's not that much to it, but it just shows you some of the things that you can actually get done. So we'll just start off with the interface. You should all have something that looks vaguely similar, except you'll have a blank canvas that you're actually working with. So we start off with the scene up at the top. That's your 3D palette, and that's what we're going to draw onto. There's a button up next to it on top, game, which you actually use for actually playing what you've done live. You've got hierarchy. The hierarchy is basically the aspects of the game that you're actually working with, items that will appear on the map. And the project is actually a list of assets that you've imported in to this particular scene, which you're going to make use of and drag onto the canvas for the start. On the right hand side, you've got the inspector, and depending on what you click on the hierarchy of the project, the inspector changes, you get different settings, you can change what's in the environment. You can use it for changing the position, you can use it for changing the size of it. But of course you can also do a lot of these things manually as well. Up on the top, the only real bits that we're going to worry about is the hand button. With the hand button selected and rolling back and forth on your roller ball on the mouse, we'll actually zoom in and out of your scene. If you hold down the left mouse button, it shifts left and right, and then if you right click, it pivots on your screen, and we'll use that throughout to actually move around our islands. Clicking the crosshairs allows you to move objects, so if you have an object on the map, you can then click it, and then you can either drag it down manually or use the buttons that actually set it. And then finally you've got the rotate there, which will allow us to change angles of what objects are on there, because we're working in a 3D space. So the first thing we're going to do is just make sure that we have a new and empty project to work on. So what we want to do is click File, a new project. You'll find the files that I up at the top. The thing you'll find about Apple menus is Apple menus always sit up on the top bar, as opposed to having an individual file menu for each application. It's a little bit getting used to. So once you've gotten creating a project, delete off the bit that says new Unity project, whatever number it is, and give it a name. Or anything that you actually like. And then make sure you take the character controller and the terrain assets. and then like create a project. Well, there's the upload down unity and restart it up again. And you'll end up pretty much with the same sort of scene as what you had before, but it's going to have your name on it. And basically, in the project section under standard assets, you can click the triangle and you'll see the two assets that we imported already. One thing that I forgot to mention was this gizmo that's up there in the scene. That's going to allow us to change the perspective of what we're looking at generally. Looking at it in an isometric sort of view. Clicking Y will give you an overhead look. Clicking on the red will look on the x-axis and clicking on the view across the z-axis. We'll come across that a little bit later. So the first thing that we're actually going to do is we're going to create a terrain which we're going to place our island on. It's going to be our island. Later on we'll add in other things, but we'll start off with that terrain. So if you go up to the top there and look for the menu item terrain, and click create terrain. What that's going to do is that's going to create at the origin point, which is 000, in this world space, and that's going to create an area that's actually 2,000 by 2,000 large. That's probably a little bit big for working on today, so we're going to shrink that a little bit. So again, click terrain again, and click set resolution. Now if you want to work with a big island, so let's make it 1,000, but I recommend change the terrain width 600 and the terrain length. And then accept the resolution. So now we should have something that looks at least part of a grey square sitting on our map. Everybody there okay? No problem so far? Now what we're actually going to do with this is sitting down at a very low level, and what we're going to want to do, we're going to raise this up, because later on we're going to sink the sides down a bit to give us an island, and now we can sort of float some water in amongst there. So once again, go to terrain and click flatten height map, and where height says 0, change that to 30. And you won't see that much of a visible difference on there, but it has raised that off the ground just a little bit. Alright, so now what we actually need to do is we need to zoom it out a little bit so that we can actually get to see our full square in all its glory. Probably the easiest way to do that is to click the Y button. So that gives you an overhead view. And then if you roll back on the mouse, you should actually see that it starts to form square. If it's off the edge, then hold down the left mouse button and pull it down until you get that square shape into your screen. And when you've got it, click the cube in the middle of the gizmo and you should go back to a perspective view and end up with a square. Okay, somebody else doing okay?
Brilliant. Fantastic.
Right, now what we're actually going to do is we're actually going to sink the marine down a bit. So that's taking the edges and lowering them back down to the ground level. So we do that by making sure that terrain is clipped in our hierarchy. And you'll see that the inspector on the right hand side should look the same as what mine does. And if we click this button here on the left hand side, that's for raising and lowering the terrain. Click that button. A bit of information so that underneath changes. And go into to lower it down. So I'd actually recommend taking the second brush in and possibly making the brush size a little bit bigger. And when you roll the mouse over your island, you should actually see a small blue dot underneath it. It's not very clear on that one. I'm going over a big dot there, and that's going to show more of that. If you hold down the shift key, then start dragging it around the edge of your island, you should actually see it starting to take chunks out of the side of it. So make it small, or as big as you actually want. What this is going to give us is some cliff beaches, cliffs. If you're not managing to get all around it, so I click on the Y button, which gives you that overhead look. And then draw your wrist around. And then when we're finished, we should have kind of a squarish shape with dodgy edges. And if you want to, somewhere on your island, thinking of it, but that will be a bit of a leak, so that's a thing.